Ferguson wants you to know that he is looking out for your pocketbook, and he's sending you some chicken checks to prove it. Let's get to it in our segment, Unbelievable. All right, what do I mean by chicken checks? So Washington State and Attorney General Bob Ferguson, they were part of a lawsuit against some tuna and chicken producers for price fixing conspiracies that they say cost Washingtonians millions of dollars. So they ended up getting $40.6 million that they are now going to send back out to some Washingtonians in the form of a little check from the office of Attorney General Bob Ferguson. I'll tell you who qualifies for the checks momentarily, but this is how Bob Ferguson talked about it on his campaign. This is important. This is what he posted on his campaign Twitter, not his official Attorney General Twitter. So to think that Bob Ferguson is not going to take advantage of the fact that he is his office personally sending out checks to Washingtonians while he's also running for governor, of course he's got to take advantage of that. He says, one in six Washingtonians lives in a household that will receive a check. In all, my office has put $270 million back in Washingtonians' pockets, not to mention the hundreds of millions we've won in debt relief. Happy holidays. I hope the money makes a difference, which is so tone deaf because some of these checks are like $50. I want you to know. He says grocery budgets only stretch so far, especially these days. No mention of why? No, you don't want to talk about why our grocery budget isn't going as far? He says it's unconscionable that companies would illegally conspire to raise prices even more. Today we're taking money from companies that cheated hardworking Washingtonians and returning it to those they cheated. Man, I can think of another person who's cheating hardworking Washingtonians. Jay Inslee. I wonder if you're going to return some of the gas money that people have had to cough up because of the Climate Commitment Act, but I digress. So if you haven't received one of these chicken checks yet, you might not, because it's going to people who have a household income that is 175% of the federal poverty line and below. So some examples of that. If you've got a family of five with a household income less than $61,000. If you're a single parent raising three kids on an income of $52,000 or less. If you're a single parent with two children making less than $43,000. If you're a single parent of one child or a retired couple living on two fixed incomes that total less than $34,000. Or if you're a retired individual who lives alone on a fixed income less than $25,000 a year. So single-person households, you're going to get a check for $50. Multi-person households, you're going to get a check for $120. Now, what do these checks look like? So you're going to get, the envelope is going to be from attorney, it's going to say Bob Ferguson, Attorney General, on the envelope. You're going to get an old letter from Bob himself, and the check itself is going to say Bob Ferguson, Attorney General of Washington. And then it's going to have the amount that you're getting on it. This was sent to us by a viewer who said that, and this is the funny part. We've blacked out the name, obviously, but she got it. Well, her dad got it, right, Nicole? Because you communicated with her.
Right. So it was addressed to her dad with her sister's middle name, and it was to her address. So yeah. Her dad doesn't live with her. Her sister is not part of this, and
so it's like
it came to her.
I don't even know if they can cash this check, but the letter that comes with it says, good news, you're receiving a refund. Dear so-and-so, as Attorney General, one of my top priorities is protecting consumers from fraud and deception. When corporations do not play by the rules, my team and I take action. My office filed lawsuits against more than 20 corporations that make and sell chicken and canned tuna because they secretly agreed to raise prices for these products. Their motive was simple, greed. Their actions violated state and federal laws that encourage competition in the marketplace and help keep prices down for consumers. As a result of their illegal activity, you paid more than you should have for chicken and canned tuna. Hardworking Washingtonians cannot afford to be cheated by large corporations. Most of our lawsuits are now resolved, and these corporations must pay my office over $40 million. I am returning this money to Washingtonians like you who were most harmed by their illegal conduct. And again, he's currently running for governor. Now look, I agree that if there's clear-cut examples of price fixing, I'm not taking issue with his office going after this money. I'm not even taking office or issue with his office returning the money. Although I'll say there is no burden of proof here that you bought the chicken in question, that you bought the canned tuna in question. It's basically saying, and I don't know how they would do that. That would sound like a mess. So they're just like, okay, let's give it to the poorest Washingtonian. So that's just, I want you to know that it's not like you had to send in a receipt saying, hey, I bought some chicken or canned tuna or whatever it is. Now, one of the things that really grinds my gears about this is how much Democrats lost their ever-loving minds when Trump did something just like this with stimulus checks. Do you remember the headlines? Because the stimulus checks were going to have Trump's name on it, and he sent a letter, and they were going to come in an envelope from the president. Some of the headlines: in unprecedented move, Treasury orders Trump's names printed on stimulus checks. Getting a stimulus check, Trump's name will be on it. Stimulus checks to bear Trump's name, an unprecedented move. How did Trump's name end up on coronavirus relief checks in 2020? ABC News successfully sued to find out. I mean, ABC sued about it. It's crazy. Trump wants his name on millions of stimulus checks, even if it delays them. Now, look, I don't know what Trump's motivation was either. I mean, I don't know if it certainly didn't seem like Trump's name had to be on the checks. Do I think that he wanted Americans to know, hey, I'm the president and this looks really good for me while I'm running for re-election, that you've got the... of course I think that. And I also think it with Attorney General Bob Ferguson. I think, you know, Trump did it when he was going to run for re-election. Bob Ferguson does it when he's running for governor, and conveniently leaves out all the other ways that his office has screwed Washingtonians out of money by pursuing fruitless, politically motivated legal action, by hiding documentation during court proceedings where his office then had to pay fines. Like, let's conveniently leave all of that out. And let me write a big old letter and send a check to people that talking about how great I am and how I work. I look out for hardworking Washingtonians. Well, my friend, Governor Jay Inslee, who's endorsed my campaigns, doesn't care at all about hardworking Washingtonians and won't even admit that his own policies have raised prices at the gas pump. So, I mean, I digress. No moral consistency. No moral consistency. Now, Shift Washington, which is sort of like a center-right entity, called out Bob Ferguson for some of this on Twitter. I was actually surprised he responds. He never responds to criticism. They said, hey, Bob Ferguson, be transparent. Tally up the numbers of all the state's losses under your partisan attack approach, starting with the Value Village debacle. Or maybe some reporter could add that up for the AG, since sixth grade math eludes Washington, allegedly, referring to the fact that sixth grade math shows us that, of course, the carbon tax was going to increase gas prices. But you still see this Inslee administration and his political allies denying that. But he was referring to Value Village, which was a crazy case that Washington State lost, had to pay Value Village a bunch of money because Bob Ferguson went after them without following his offices and the laws and the protocols in place for going after a nonprofit that they think is skirting the rules. So wasted a bunch of money, wasted a bunch of time. Bob Ferguson responds, sure, Value Village is my only unsuccessful consumer protection case as Attorney General. We were generally successful at the trial court, but lost at the Supreme Court. I reimbursed Value Village's costs and fees from proceeds from legal victories, not taxpayer funds.
Wait a minute.
Bob Ferguson, every dime your office makes is taxpayer funds. Every single dime your office gets from legal victories then becomes a taxpayer fund.